Hello, boys and girls. My name is Mike Kelly, animatorsforum.com. I'm going to do this real, real quick. Somebody was asking about collision shapes. I mentioned this in passing, and I think I've shown this in a couple videos, but I was searching through and I couldn't find any. So I'll do this. Character Creator 3 doesn't come with collision shapes enabled, or if it does, the shapes aren't very good. So I've talked about this in the past, on a couple of videos, so I thought I would show you this real quick. If you're going to do anything with physics on the characters, you want to have good collision shapes. So you'll notice this doesn't have collision shapes turned on by default, and I think that's true in iClone all the time now. So we turn them on, and actually the shapes, aren't even enabled here. So you go through here, and you go through, and there's not much shapes here. You can't see the shapes. So what I always do for any character I bring in, whether it's Character Creator 3 or even in iClone, is I load in shapes, and I load them in from an old character. I load them in from Natalie. Natalie is a character from, from previous versions of iClone. I'm not even sure where she comes from. But her shapes are more intense, and there's more of them. You'll notice that here's the spine. There's a lot of different shapes for the spine. If we move around here, you'll see that she's got tons of shapes. If we try loading in some of the other characters, they don't have as many shapes. For the more recent versions, you know, she has lots of hip shapes inside here. And for some reason, in other versions of iClone, they didn't make the shapes as good. So like your custom characters now don't have all these custom shapes. So what I did was I found Natalie, and in this older version, I think she was an iClone 5? I don't know, maybe iClone 6? She's somewhere. And I think you can find her yourself. I think she's still available somewhere. I've moved around so many characters and things, I can't even begin to tell you where I have her now. Let's see, I'm trying to think about where I even have her. Yeah, I moved things around, so I don't know where I had her. I had her somewhere. Let's see. Oh, well. Anyway, wherever she is, she's an old character, Natalie. If you can find her somewhere, I don't think there'd be any problem with me posting the collision shapes if you can't find her somewhere. Maybe I'll post the collision shape file here. I can't imagine that would be a problem. And if Reillusion doesn't like it, they can let me know. But basically, you go ahead and save them out. If you find Natalie, save them out. But I will. I'll post a little bit of link to the Natalie shapes that you can load in. And while there are more of them, I think they would slow collisions down, maybe if you had a lot of characters on screen. For clothing, I just use the Natalie shapes on my computer, and they work just fine. So that's what I recommend. I'll make this video short. I'll post a link to the Natalie shapes in the bottom. And if anybody wants, you can use those. For men, it isn't. I do have men's shapes as well, but I haven't found them to be as much of a problem. I use Christian, so Natalie and Christian are the two characters I use. So you could load in. I'll post links to both of those. Natalie and Christian. Those are the links I recommend instead of the ones that come in naturally, and I think you'll have better collisions on there. And of course, you can always adjust collision shapes, and you can look in the manual about how to do that if you have any problems with clothing not intersecting. But I find that those shapes loaded in need very little adjustment. They seem to be that work just fine. So, okay, hopefully that solves your problem with collision shapes if you have it, and we'll see you around the forums.